Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be all about this eye look that I have going on right here. Kind of cool tones, I'm not gonna lie. I really do want to apologize because I did see this look on Instagram and I didn't use like the exact products that this artist used, whatever. And I'm so upset at myself that I didn't screenshot it because I really do want to give her credit. So if you did make this look and you posted it on Instagram, please let me know. If you know of the person, please let me know because I would love to give creds to her. I was just on the explore page and I saw it and I was like, oh my god, that's so nice. And I don't know why I didn't screenshot it because I screenshot a lot of things. But, you know, whatever. So yeah, this look is just going to be based on eye look that I'm wearing right now. It's super dramatic. I feel like it's coming off blue because I did use like cooler tones. I used like blacks and grays, so I feel like it looks blue, but it is black. I've been buying a lot of makeup lately. Not that I need it, but I've just been like hunting around for new makeup products and stuff because I've just been hunting around and looking for new makeup products and stuff because I always use Kat Von D, I always use Makeup Geek, I always use the Kat Von D Shade Light Palette, or I always use, you know, like my Makeup Geek shadows or my Anastasia shadows or an Anastasia palette, and it's just like, I need to use different things. So, I've been ordering a lot of stuff online. Go ahead and check out my Instagram. I'll leave it in the screen. It pretty much just stays in the screen the whole entire time. You can go follow me on there and I will also link it down below. But I posted a picture of all of the stuff that I've bought. So if you guys want to see, go ahead and follow me and give it a like. But one of the things that I bought is this VISEART palette. And I've had my eyes on these for so long. But they're just so much money. They're like 80 bucks. But because Christmas and my birthday was so close to each other, I got a bunch of Sephora gift cards. So it went to this bad boy. It's not the only thing that I bought, but pretty much this is just like so stunning. I absolutely love it. I absolutely love it. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will leave my previous video linked down below because I skipped my whole entire face because I filmed that already. So I will link that down below. But if you guys want to see how I got this eye look, then go ahead and keep on watching. I'll leave all of my social media down below so you guys can go ahead and follow. And don't forget to subscribe if you're not already. All it does is just give you a notification for when I upload a video, which I'm trying to do 2 to 3 times a week. I'm getting there. So just have a little faith in me. If you guys want to go ahead and see how I got this look, then please keep watching. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my VISEART palette. This is in the shade number 1 neutral matte. And I'm going to go ahead and put this color right here into my crease as our transition shade, Morphe E53. These shades are pretty pigmented, so just be careful. It's okay if you get it on your lid. I have hooded lids, so I'm obviously gonna end up getting some sort of product on my lid. I already primed my lids. I used my concealer because my eyes were looking super red today and veiny. So I used my Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer and then I set it with the Velour Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. I grab a Morphe M433. Looks like this. Mine's a little bit dirty. I'm going to grab this Morphe M433 and I'm going to grab these shades in the palette. I'm going to mix them together. We're going to focus just on this row. It's going to be more of a cooler toned look. So I'm just going to mix them and I'm going to keep my eye open slightly, blend on the outer crease. Outer V, if I should say, on the lid and a little bit on the crease. And then in just slightly. You guys can pick up a different brush for this if you want. Then with whatever leftover product, I'm just going to blend that in and out of my crease as well. I put that orangey peachy shade in the crease because if you use too much coolness, a little bit black and blue, so the warmer tones will help balance it out. To a MAC 221 brush, this is really nice. It's one of their new brushes that they just came out with. I love, love, love this brush. And it's nice and fluffy, and it has like a denser point, so it's... I'm gonna go back in with that Morphe brush and that first shade that we picked up, and I'm gonna go ahead and blend that out, make sure we have no harsh lines. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and grab that dark brown shade first. I went in with this shade on my previous eye and it just looks super blue to me. So I'm going to go in with the dark brown first instead of the other shade and see if that makes a difference. I combine the brush that I'm going to use. Okay, super big. This step is also great for you guys who are scared of black. I know, I've been there before. Black is a super hard color to blend out, especially if you've messed up. So going in with a darker brown or darker gray, going in with a darker brown or darker gray will really help. And then again, blend the excess in and out of the crease. Okay, so I actually like that a lot better than when I put the gray in. Let's just hope my eyes match. I'm gonna go in with this black shade from the palette. It's just, you know, the black shade right there. This palette is super pigmented. And then you can go ahead and blend it out. And go ahead and just blend it out the final time, because now I'm going to go in with the lid shade. I'm gonna go in with the white. I'm gonna go in with the white from the palette and just put that all over our lid. Wherever we don't have. You can go in with like a cream base here if you want, but I'm just gonna go in with old-fashioned white eyeshadow. I'm going in with Kat Von D's ThunderStruck eyeshadow. This is one of her Metal Crush eyeshadows. These are so amazing. They're so creamy and pigmented and they're just like so beautiful. I love this shade as a highlighter on like the skin when I'm feeling a little pale. I'm gonna go ahead and wet my brush with some MAC Fix Plus. Dip it in the ThunderStruck eyeshadow again. Pack it on the center and then just take a brush that has no product on it and just sweep it so there's no harsh lines. And since we just wet our brush, I'm gonna go in with a glitter. This is MAC Reflex Gold. It's in this little pot here. And because I'm only putting in a little bit, like sporadically around my lid, I don't really need that glitter glue. And we already wet our brush, so I'm just gonna go in like that. I'm gonna grab this Marc Jacobs eyeliner. This is from Sephora. It's like their new birthday gift. And I'm gonna tight line and do my lower. I'm gonna go in with mascara. I'm using the L'Oreal Voluminous mascara in Carmen Black. Go ahead and put our lashes, go on our lashes because that's going to take a minute as well. I'm going in with the Velour lashes in the style Naughty Me, like this. They're not too like voluminous. I'm going to go in with my lower lash line, so I'm going to go in with these shades again and just mix them and just throw them on my lower lash line. I'm not gonna go in like too intense. I want the lower lash line to be pretty smoky-ish, but not like super, super, super intense. I am gonna make sure that I connect this outer corner on the lid to the outer corner on the lower lash line. Go ahead and just take one of these lighter colors. I kind of just mixed all of them together. And I'm just going to blend. Okay, so this is the final look for my lips. I put on the new MAC liquid lipstick. It's called the Retro Matte Liquid Lip Color. This is in the shade Lady Be Good. It's a pretty nice nude shade. It was a little bit too like on the orangey, warmish side for me. So on the center of my lips, I put the new Tarte lip paint in the shade Namaste. I've been wearing this nonstop since I got it, and I absolutely love it. So this is my lip combo. My camera died, and I was just like, you know what, screw it, let me just put them on, and then I'll tell you what I used. So yep, this is my lip combo. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and don't forget to subscribe. I will leave all of my social media links down below, and it'll also be in the screen as per usual. So go ahead and check that out, and I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye.